Twitter Tuesday featuring heightened expectations for your Dallas Cowboys following the stunning win over the Saints Sunday night. Jerry Jones has stayed away from bold predictions about this team, but Drew Davidson of the Star-Telegram notes that on his 105.3 The Fan radio show, Jerry says, "We're way ahead of my expectations." Great stat here, ESPN's Tim McMahon pointing out that DeMarco Murray has rushed for 327 yards before contact. Only two backs have more rushing yardage, period. Of course, that speaks volumes about that young offensive line. From ESPN's Ed Werder, Kyle Orton, now the Bills' starting quarterback, after forcing his way out of Dallas. Not a good relationship with Tony Romo. Hated the offensive power struggle. He was a backup quarterback. Did it really matter that much to him? Did you see this? Kansas City safety Hussein Abdullah scoring a touchdown last night, and as a devout Muslim, goes to the ground in prayer and is penalized for excessive celebration. You can't go to the ground to celebrate. Well, NFL Today reverses field, pointing out that in the case of religious demonstration, it is okay to go to the ground, so he won't be fined. If he had knelt and made the sign of the cross, would he have been penalized? I don't think so. For his part, Abdullah has been really classy about this thing. He could really be taking the league to task if he wanted to. Instead, on his Twitter feed, he simply thanks everybody for their support. Hashtag peace. More legal problems for Olympic champion Michael Phelps, arrested for DUI in his hometown of Baltimore. CNBC Sports Biz offering a link to Phelps' statement. He apologizes to everybody. Phelps was also arrested for drunken driving in 2004. The Baylor UT trash talk ramping up ahead of the matchup Saturday night in Austin. Former Longhorns receiver Quan Cosby tweeting, "It's so funny that Baylor fans are talking crap this week. I don't remember once talking when I beat you four times or you sucked for 30 years. Living in the past, it's come to that for the Longhorns on Twitter Tuesday.